person that bought it.
If you ask consumers that, they will regularly tell you across the consumer spectrum that they think it's about 45%. That's the number that graphics is totally wrong. So when we study female fashion innovators, feminine presenting fashion innovators, they're the worst case scenario. They have the biggest wardrobes and they wear the least of it. They're actually wearing something like 5 to 7% of their wardrobes regularly. For male fashion or masculine presenting fashion innovators, that goes up a little bit to about 30%. But most of those participants can't wear all of their clothes once per month or more if they wanted to. Their wardrobes are too large. At the same time, none of them are satisfied. None of them think that, they have a beautiful, efficient wardrobe system where they're using everything they need.
Nobody's clever, right? Like, let's just stop making the stuff no one wants. And then we, reduce our impact by a lot without, why this is happening. Nobody's idea is perfect, otherwise we wouldn't still have practice. We would all sort of competitive in this industry, but just to kind of take a pulse of what's happening right now across different brands and how are people thinking about their practice. So one thing we've discovered is that the customer is a concept that every designer is thinking about, but it's a very vague and monolithic concept. Most designers talk about the customer in the singular. She wants this. She doesn't like when we do this. Not as several different personas, not as several different subsegments, but as a person. And many brands think that extends to things like fit modeling, where there's one fit and one, not her body that they're putting clothes on. Most design practices rely really heavily on that designer as a tacit expert. And when I say that, I mean hands in brain and digital. AI can mean anything. Digital tools can mean anything from like a predictive model, like a statistical model, or even just when A happens, B happens. any sort of formal relationship that we can validate that happens between like cause and effect. It can be machine learning, which is statistics dressed up in a new name sometimes. Where we're training a statistical model with a lot of variables, more than just A equals B. Or it could actually be something that looks a little bit more like intelligence in the body. It takes too long.
How do we aggregate that knowledge that you would get from looking at it on a lot of different bodies? What would we be looking for when we were looking at it on a lot of different bodies? Another example, one of the things that we hear from our consumer participants a lot is that they just can't find a good outfit. They've got all this clothing, they tell me they like it, they tell me they're wearing it, but every day the challenge is, oh, what am I going to wear? I like these pants, what do I wear them with? This shirt is dirty, I don't have, Putting things together is half of the battle, and each individual brand is designing, completely ignorant of that battle. It has no idea what you're trying to actually match your clothing to. So, when we measure, over 90% of garments in the closet are underused. This is a big driver, it's just matching with other stuff. Designers who